Good evening or good morning as the case may be. I am here to present the work done by my students in the Department of Civil Engineering at Jawaharlal Nehru Engineering College, Aurangabad, which is now currently known as MG University. So, the title of the project is The Design of a Multi-Arm Tunneling System for Aurangabad. It has been guided by me, and the contributors to the project are Deepti, Avanti, Kajal, Sayeda, Kulsum, and Sagar. So our motivation is that Aurangabad is now currently facing a huge traffic congestion, and there is a increased travel time. Even smaller distances are now taking a lot of time to travel. The diversion of traffic is the need of the hour. And from the tourism point of view, since Aurangabad is a tourist city, from the tourism point of view, it gives us a bad impression of the city. So that's our motivation. So there are various mediums to connect the concerned places. We can connect the places by flyovers, or we can connect the places by using tunnels. So there are merits and demerits of the flyovers. So you can, you know, with the flyovers, there are a lot of flyovers in Aurangabad right now. At least the main cities has 4 flyovers. But flyovers play a major role in streamlining the traffic. Pollution is basically reduced. But it's not suitable for congested cities like Aurangabad. A lot of construction required. No suitable places for construction are there. And of course, it will require land acquisition, which will delay the project. On the contrary, if I say tunnels, so it will avoid interference with surface traffic. So while the construction is going on, the surface traffic will be less interfered with, and there will be no problems with land acquisition. The suitable rock is available, basalt rock is there, and there, of course, the disadvantages are that rainwater may cause a lot of disturbance, but unfortunately, or fortunately for this project, you can say that rainwater is not a problem because the city receives scarce rainfall. So you can see that our idea for a tunnel is not out of the way. It's not a theoretical thing. There are people who are in Aurangabad who are talking about making a tunnel. This is an article published in the Maharashtra Times on 11th August 2017. So, we can connect the tourist spots and hospitals, and we have to find out the minimum number of tunnels that we can make. Tourist spots and hospitals. So, for tourists, anybody who is coming here, he can go inside the city, tour the things, and then go to the hospitals. If any there is a serious patient, then the person can go to the hospitals and visit quickly. Emergency cases should be able to be treated. So there are some location preferences for the center of the tunnel network. The foundations of the building must not be deep, because if there is a center of the tunnel network, we cannot have a lot of interferences with the buildings. It should be equidistant from most of the selected places. Center should be located. We are going to locate the center such that the site must be an open ground so that it interferes less with the traffic and all that. And as well, by looking at the various satellite images of Aurangabad, we propose that the tunnel network center must be at Old Monda. So this is how you can see Old Monda. It is completely blank as on date. There is no construction there. So this is the street map of Aurangabad. This street map has been downloaded from OpenStreetMap. This is the main part of the city, and this is part of the city which we are going to consider. So what are the location preferences? So the tunnel outlet and inlet, they have to be location. They have to be located, and they have to be located in vacant areas so that it does not interfere with any construction. It does not interfere with any inhabitants. It does not interfere with any living area. So therefore, we have to identify the these places, and we have to consider the proximity as well as economy. And the points are selected which cover as many places as possible. So if there is any point which can connect three places, it is good point. The acquisition of the land must be economical. So if there is any little acquisition of the land which is required, it has to be minimal, economical, that is said, cost-wise. So the you can see that the identified vacant areas are only 8. So it can cover multiple hospitals and it can also cover the tourist spots. So these are the satellite views of the selected areas, which actually clearly show that there are vacant areas which can be used for tunnel inlet and outlet. So for making the tunnel, you will have to understand whether the particular profile of the terrain is suitable for making a tunnel or not. So we use SRTM data. SRTM data is basically a remote sensing data, shuttle radar technology mission, remote sensing data, and using that remote sensing data, we can prepare a ground level profile. And we did this using GRASS GIS, and given the 9 stations, there is a possibility of 74 routes, and the profiles for all the 74 routes were generated. But we cannot create, tunnels, 74 tunnels. That is not an economical thing. So we have to select which tunnel. So these are all the profiles of the 74 routes, but after, careful study of IRC SP91-2010. Okay, so we have selected the following profiles. So what profiles? So let us see the various cross sections of the tunnel which are recommended by SP, the standard of practice. So this is a cross section. This is a D-shaped tunnel, the rectangular tunnel, the horseshoe tunnel, and the polycentric tunnel. So these are various kinds of tunnel profiles which are there, cross sections. Okay, so the cross section is selected, the D-shaped tunnel is selected because it is suitable for tunneling hard rock. So local transfer mechanism is ideal. So and proper arrangements can be done for other facilities. So it has to be, it has to carry electric cables, water flow, water tank network, and all that thing is there. Construction is relatively easy. So that's the reason why we have selected a D-shaped tunnel. So in our project, the first part is the geometric design. Geometric design of what? The roads of the tunnel. It's a road network. So when we are talking about geometric design, we have to talk about dimensions. We have to talk about horizontal curves, vertical curves, super elevations, entry and exit curves, and the curves at roundabout. So the roundabout, what I'm talking about roundabout? Roundabout is the center of the tunneling system. So the main tunnels are designed like this. So width is 7 meters each length. Of course, there is a standard. These are all standard. Each lane is of 3.35 meters. Height is 3.25 meters. So as a result, the depth of the tunnel top from ground level. So tunnel roof from the ground level, it has to be 7 meters. The radius of the roundabout will be 100 meters. And the lane width will be equal to 7 meters. And height will be 4 meters. So roundabout, so there will be multiple tunnels connecting to the roundabout, and then if there is a point, there are two points A and B, so the person will travel from A, go to the roundabout, take a turn, and then go to B. This is how the plan of the tunnel system is. Now the dimensions of the cross section as recommended here, this is the diagrammatic representation, and we are also planning entrance geometric design. Why? We want that the entry and exit of the cars or vehicles should not interfere with each other. So therefore, a geometric design, separate entry and exit for each point. So horizontal curves are done like this. So you can see there is a formula as is presented in the Transportation Engineering book by N.L. Arora. So this is a main tunnel. The horizontal curve is given by this particular formula, and the sample calculation is given. So using the sample calculation, we can see what kind of curve we will have. So So if there is a 32-seater Cantor bus, the Cantor bus is a simple 32-seater lightweight vehicle. So if there is a 32-seater bus, so this is how the length of the curve should be. So based on these, you know, this calculation is based on NL Arora and Justo and Khanna. So as a result, we plan this entry and exit horizontal curves here. And horizontal curve at roundabout, this is how the horizontal curve at roundabout looks like. Then of course there will be a vertical alignment case, because you will have to see why we need a vertical alignment. You have to understand that you will travel down, then flat, then up maybe, and as a result you will need a particular slope of the ground. The inclination of 15 degrees is assumed here, and therefore this vertical alignment, the inclination of the ramp with respect to a tunnel base should not exceed 25 degrees. The inclination of 15 degrees we are assuming here, so that is the vertical alignment that we are talking about. So for 15 meters down travel, we will have 60 meters of horizontal travel. That's the vertical alignment. So we can calculate the super elevation also like this, and as per Justo and Khanna's book, we have calculated the super elevation. What is super elevation? The banking, basically. What we are talking about, the banking. So now we are going to do a geological study. Why do we need a geological study? Pretty simple. If I have to make a tunnel, we have to see whether the area is geologically suitable for this particular construction. So for geological study, we see that the Deccan trap basalt is there, compact basalt 2 to 15 meters, amygdaloidal basalt is 10 to 20 meters, vesicular basalt 10 to 20 meters, and red bold basalt up to 3 meters. And this is the standard government document which is saying Ministry of Water Resources from Central Water Ground Board. Geohydrological study survey report is there. And based on this geohydrological survey report, we have found out that this is what it is. So major rock which is there under Aurangabad is Deccan Trap Basalt. So this is the map which is there in that report, and we have taken this map from there. So this is the geological map. All the brown colored areas are hilly areas. There are soft rocks in a very, very scarce quantity, but mostly it is hard rock. You can see this here. Now inside a tunnel you will need a lighting, of course, and when you are talking about lighting inside a tunnel, you have to make sure that the driver inside the tunnel does not get hypnotized. So therefore we have to fit the frequency of the lights in such a way so that the driver does not get hypnotized. That is very important here. So there will be a change in the brightness, the external brightness and the internal brightness. If there is a major difference in that particular brightness, then what will happen is the black hole effect will happen, and it can result in a collision of vehicles. So lighting has three parts. This is entrance lighting, interior lighting, and lighting at exit. So all the lighting has to be designed properly. So the thing is, we can consider using CFLs or LED bulbs, and the design of lighting is for a length of 10 meters. The standard lux is 250, lumens are 4620, and we are considering an LED bulb of 1700 lumens. Number of bulbs is 2.7. So we'll not take 2.7, we will take 2 bulbs each at a spacing of 10 meters. So this is how the light layout will be given. Now we are going to talk about toilets. Why should we talk about the toilets inside the tunnel network? Suppose there is a patient. We are basically talking about creating the tunnel system for patients and tourists. The tourists or the patient might need to use the toilet, and therefore we are proposing green toilets inside. Why green? Because if I make a non-green toilet, I have to create facilities for draining out the water also. So we are proposing the green toilet. So this is a green toilet design, and we'll have a size of the pot which is a standard size of the pot, and this is how the dimensions are, and we will make the tank which is made of concrete and brick walls, and it will contain a biodigester unit. So all the urine that will be released inside the toilet will be biodigested, and there will be no need for draining the toilet out. So this is the top view of the toilet as seen in that screen. So while the person is using the toilet, you need to park the vehicle, and therefore you need to create a space for the parking also, so that it does not interfere with the traffic. So as a result, you will need to create a curb here. There is a parking plan for the toilets is shown right on the screen. So this is a 3D view of the parking plan. So now we are going to talk about exhaust and supply of fresh air. So inside the tunnel, there will be people, and we have to consider the exhaust and supply of fresh air based on worst case scenario. So we are going to design the ventilation based on two considerations will be there. So supply of fresh air is there, and the exhaust of pollutant, so both have to be considered. So we are going to design what we call as a full traverse ventilation system. So this is a sample calculation. Sample calculation is based on standard emission of pollutants. So we are assuming that every vehicle is checked, every vehicle which is going inside the tunnel has a standard emission, and vehicle plus human emission. So number of vehicles plus the number of humans, and assuming that the number of persons inside the tunnel is 10,336. So this is based on this calculation, we are going to design the exhaust fans and the supply of fresh air. All the design is being seen here. Now we are going to talk about safety preparedness. What safety preparedness we're talking about? Fire conditions can happen inside the tunnel. So in the fire safety, flooding case, and structural failures, all three things can happen. So we have to be prepared for that safety. So a firefighting system can be designed. The firefighting system can release waters at demand, and obviously wet pipe water mist system will be there. Wet pipe means that the water will be already present there, and the material of the pipe used for the firefighting will be copper tube. So this is on the screen you can see the plan for the smoke detectors. So the flooding, in case of a flooding, so there are remedial measures. So one is what the plan is, that we design the entry ramp and exit ramp such that the water does not enter the ramp itself. So the height of the ramp is more than the annual average rainfall of the city. So the annual average rainfall of Aurangabad is 638 mm. So we plan the height of the ramp more than that. That is what we are doing here. So in case of structural failure, that means the seepage of groundwater, earthquake, etc. So in case of the seepage of groundwater, waterproof concrete lining has to be done. In case of earthquake, we have to consider the seismic loads while there is designing. Why this is not an important issue here? This Aurangabad is not a earthquake prone area as on date. Okay. So inadequate exhaust will lead to formation of vacuum. So therefore, balancing of exhaust and supply of fresh air is very important here. Now we are talking about networking. Why this networking is required? Remember that inside a tunnel, we will require security arrangement. So we need a security cameras and all that. So for that, for connecting the security camera to monitor the system, we will require networking. So in case we want to report certain emergencies, we will require networking. So there will be telephone wires and CCTV network and Wi-Fi. So all this is a part of networking here. So this is the standard FLIR traffic sense camera at the spacing of 25 meters. It has got these Wi-Fi boosters at every 200 meters inside the channel. These are all standard devices available in the market. And telephone wires will be as per spacing recommended in IRCSP. So telephone wires are there. So these are the design as seen in the for traffic sense cameras, Wi-Fi boosters, and telephone wires. Now we are going to talk about pavement design. Now the pavement design is very important. So we are going to design. There are two types of pavement. There is rigid pavement and flexible pavement. So we are going to use M30 concrete, and based on that, the characteristic strength of concrete based on standard IS codes, the characteristic strength of concrete will be 39.04 kg per centimeter square. And there will be a spacing of expansion joints will be there. Pavement width is not more than 4.5 meters. Contraction joints are not provided inside the tunnel. The thickness of the concrete slabs which will be used in the pavement will be 160 mm. So this is these are the curves which have been referred to for designing the rigid pavement. Now we are talking about structural design and analysis. So structural design, so there will be a heel slab, there will be toe slab, and there will be vertical wall, and all this will be done using steel bars, so 16 mm bars and 10 mm bars. And here then we talk about costing. So after we have said the specification, we have mentioned the specifications of so many things, we are finally going to talk about the costing of the project. So the excavation cost is so much, and as a result we have got 2995 crores as the costing of the project. Now there will be a requirement of revenue generation or recovery of this cost investment from the government. So therefore, we have planned a roundabout, you remember that. In the beginning of the project, we have planned a roundabout. And therefore, on the roundabout, we are planning a service building. So it is going to serve most of its purposes. It will be, containing the tunnel control room. It will contain the water storage tank. And it will contain restaurants, etc. So, and then it will, contain, food outlets, gym, tennis court, banquet hall, meeting halls, whatever. And also it will have control room and water storage. So this is the revenue generation part is there, and the service provision part is also there in the service building. So this is the AutoCAD drawing, the elevation drawing of the service building. This is how it is looking like. All right. So as a result, so this is on the ground floor of the building, there will be a weekly market. So that particular Monda area is already a market. So we are not going to displace those people here. We are going to provide a space for them for the weekly market, and the market provisions which are procured, and they can be used by the food court or sitting area which is inside the service building. So this is the first floor, and it will contain so many things like banquet hall, etc. This is the underground parking floor. The service building will contain another underground parking floor for two wheelers and three wheelers and four wheelers, whatever. And inside this water storage tank, there will be green toilets, drinking water, food boilers, and multiplex. So all that, there will be drinking water and there will be potable water. And so of course, there will be grey water and potable water, both will be there. Cleaning utensils, the potable water will be used for cleaning utensils and etc. all that. And finally, revenue generation is done through this particular thing. So we have ignored in our calculations the revenue generated through toll. There are several gaps in our work. Design of pavement is limited to only LCVs. And finite element analysis of the proposed tunnel network is also not done. Pumping of the sewage is not considered here. So a lot of future scope is there. You can design an intelligent vehicle transport system. Finite element analysis of the tunnel network can be integrated. Smart traffic control system, pavement design of high duty vehicles. And the achievement is that we won the best project in Swayampur 2018. Thank you.